Transmission begins.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
This is the Josh Tolley Show on the GCN Radio Network.
Our next guest retired from the Navy as Lieutenant Commander. And if that wasn't enough, she went on to the Florida House of Representatives. Not stopping there, she then became Lieutenant Governor of the state of Florida. I'm talking about, successful-minded. She even wrote her own autobiography, When You Get There. And she joins us now to talk about, I guess, this idea of where's all this information in D.C. coming from, where's it going, and what damage is it causing. Her name is Jennifer Carroll, Lieutenant Governor Jennifer Carroll, that is. Welcome to the show, ma'am. How you doing?
Thanks for having me. Interesting times in Washington, D.C. It seems like every day is a never-ending news cycle.
Yeah, it is. I mean, we've always heard for years now, we live in a 24-hour news cycle. But in the past, 5.5 months, it's never been more intense than it is now.
And most of it is press generated as well as Donald Trump generated. And the press feeds off of Donald Trump's tweets and then capitalize on that monetarily. So it's all self-aggrandizing when it comes to that. But of late, now we have a General Sessions going to be testifying before the Congress. Then we had Comey last week testifying before the Senate. And here we are today with the Democrats pushing for impeachment of the president for obstruction of justice. How do we get to this point?
Well, exactly. And what's interesting about this, and I'm so glad you're on to talk about it. We have Comey who came out and essentially said, yes, Loretta Lynch, the Bill Clinton thing, the conspiracy theory that everybody thought was absolutely true. He said that's the reason he backed off of Hillary Clinton. If we're going to do obstruction of justice charges, there should be police cars in Hillary Clinton's Chappaquiddick, whatever house right now today.
The problem is that this is so political, straight down the line, it's clear for anyone to see, even Ray Charles can see it. The bottom line is, if we're truly looking for corruption, if we're truly looking for collusion, which the Russia investigation started out with, Trump and his team during the campaign colluded with the Russians. Well, Comey debunked that during his testimony, that there was no evidence of that. Then it went to who spoke with the Russians. Jared Kushner spoke with the Russians. Sessions spoke with the Russians. If that's the case, then everybody ought to be in jail, because every one of the congressional members, plus the president and Hillary Clinton and even Bernie Sanders, has spent his honeymoon in Soviet Union. So, therefore, we can't speak with the Russians. And now it's obstruction of justice. Well, if it's truly about obstruction of justice, let's be honest. When Bill Clinton and Loretta Lynch was on a tarmac during an investigation of his wife, then candidate Hillary Clinton, and then now that we've learned that Loretta Lynch was in cahoots with the FBI and the executive office, with never charging Hillary for anything and calling her investigation a matter, and Comey going along with that, masking the type of investigation that was occurring, to have the same language that was afforded to the Clinton campaign to say it was a matter, that she was not under investigation. All those were lies and cover up and colluding with a campaign. That should be the investigation.
Yeah, it should be. And with an admission like that, do you think both Clintons, Loretta Lynch and Comey, should be indicted?
Well, you see, the problem is, here comes the kicker. When it comes to an indictment now, they have to be able to show probable cause. Well, what happened with all of the materials that were damaged? Why was government property destroyed? The BlackBerry phones and the laptops. Why were those things destroyed? Where were the emails that Comey claimed that was there and then it wasn't there? So if those things were destroyed, and then Hillary Clinton herself had these things bleached, bit or whatever it is to erase any footprint of any wrongdoings, and then her server was also destroyed, how then do we get to that point of saying that there is probable cause where the evidence have been destroyed?
Well, and that brings up a very interesting question. Was the whole email server thing just kind of a surface issue, and the reality is the destruction was really the destruction of evidence for the criminal investigation and the issues that you were just addressing?
Well, I think it's twofold, because if the sensitivity of the documents on Hillary Clinton's servers, because she had multiple servers, was of national security information and sensitivity thereabouts, and that information was transmitted over a non-secure server and also distributed to people like Huma Abedin's husband, who did not have a security clearance to handle that information, then that is a crime in itself. So did the FBI destroy those evidence or that evidence to showcase that this information actually occurred or this situation actually occurred? James Comey himself should be answering those sort of questions, not that he was too scared to tell President Trump that he didn't feel comfortable in answering his questions or he didn't feel comfortable in being with him in the same room. Well, by Christ, if you as the FBI director, 6'8", And at the head of an organization that prides themselves in doing excellent ethical work, and you can't look at the president in his eyes and say, this is wrong what you're doing, or this is not right to ask me this, or let's stop the conversation now and get someone else in this room. If you're not strong enough to do that, you're not strong enough to run the head of the FBI agency or any other agency.
Yeah, that is very true. That is very true. So even if an indictment would be hard because of the destruction of evidence, then we should still be at least investigating Comey, Lynch, and Clinton.
Well, the other thing, too, with Comey's own admission that he colluded with Lynch to cover up that Clinton was under investigation,
yeah,
and that Lynch herself instructed Comey that, well, informed him that this investigation is not going to go anywhere, that no charges are going to be made, that ought to be investigated, because that's an obstruction right there of justice. That's collusion in an ongoing investigation. Time and time again, Comey has prided himself in saying, well, I can't talk about that because of an investigation. But now that we know that you have colluded with the Attorney General at the time in an ongoing investigation where no action was already predetermined, even the president said there was not going to be any charge or not even any smidgen of evidence without the investigation being fully completed, that lets you know in a whole circle there at the executive level, the DOJ and the FBI were working in cahoots. That does not let the American people feel that justice is equal under the law for everyone.
Oh, absolutely, especially when one side still wants to do the obstruction investigation into the current administration, yet fails to call for the same investigation into the people who just admitted they did it. Mm-hmm. That absolutely sends a chill down most American spine, saying, hey, wait a second, we can't trust the DOJ at all.
Well, and that's a shame, because we're supposed to be above board than any banana republic or any socialist type of government or any dictatorship type of government. We have a justice that's supposed to be blind, that we have the scales of justice that's supposed to weigh the evidence and the crime, et cetera, equally, no matter where the person is in their stature of life, no matter where they are in a political spectrum. But it seems as if today, only if you're on one side of the aisle or the other, that you're going to be either defended or persecuted for doing this, either the same thing or less. We
yes.
have military men and women that have done a whole lot less of handling classified information, and they ended up in jail.
Absolutely,
and
ma'am.
And here you have a former Secretary of
That's
State.
That's right. Ma'am, hold on one second. We're up against a break. I need to take this break. We'll continue right after this.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you loved what I had to say, then subscribe right here. If you hated what I had to say, subscribe right here. It's fun being mad on social media, isn't it? Either way, I'd love to hear from you. Send me an email right there.